Yeah, g'day everyone, Rowdy here again. We're here in Melbourne, still during COVID, mid-September. It's a very freezing cold day in Melbourne. And as you can see out there, the wind's blowing, the rain's coming down, and there's not a lot we can do today. But what we have found to do today is to work on a Hobie 14 mast. Here we have a Hobie 14 mast. From a long time ago, somewhere around the, who knows, the 80s. I think it might have been maybe mid 90s. And we're going to put a mast spanner on this old Hobie 14 mast. So we don't have all the problems of the mast rotation jamming on the mast step on the 14 front bar, or have it skipping over the top and over rotating. All sorts of problems like that. So with a mast spanner, you can actually set the position of the mast and not have to worry about it jamming during a tack or a jibe. So we're going to get into this, but the first thing we want to do is knock off the end cap to see what's up the mast, to see whether there is a foam plug, but there probably isn't. There's probably only one just here. So we're going to inspect to see what's inside this mast, so that once we've done the job, it's going to be waterproof if the boat goes turtle upside down, and we don't want that to happen, otherwise you'll never get your boat up. So we're going to check to see what's inside this mast. And this is a 3/16 drill bit, drilling these rivets out. Off she comes. And you can see in here, there is a silicon plug. But it's probably only in the end here. It probably won't go up to the mast spanner. As we can see, I've got some of this off, but there's a lot of water dripping out of this mast. It's actually got water in it. It's actually, there is a plug here, but under this plug, it's been dripping for a while. So I'm thinking there's quite a bit of water behind this. You can actually see the plug moving. It hasn't really sealed over the years. It's dripping out of the plug, so it's getting in either in here or somewhere further up the mast. So we'll have to leak test it later to see where this water's coming in. Got this plate out, and there's quite a bit of water coming out of this mast. Quite a bit of water up the guts there. So we're going to at least reseal it and put a plug further up above the mast spanner, so it'll be sealed above the mast spanner. So this old mast had a piece of aluminium cut to size in the mast there and sealed with silicon, but it hasn't been holding over the years. It's silicon's shrunk and dried off, and it's been leaking. So we're going to replace that with a different kind of plug. There's an old main halyard horn in there, one on top there. And these three rivets here, they weren't doing anything. All they were doing was anchoring the plate so it didn't wobble. So it was the old plate was pushed up against the three rivets and then silicone many years ago. So those holes will have to be just blanked off later on. Now I've flushed the mast out with a bit of fresh water. Get rid of all that excess water that was flushed all the salt water out of it. So that's one good thing. Yeah, a little bit less water in there. We'll be able to dry it out a little bit and put the mast spanner on. So in here we've just used some steel wool, picked all the silicone off, and we're just cleaning it up with a bit of steel wool, getting it back to bare metal. So we're just going to inspect the mast spanner. From Hobie Cat, they recommend, this is all they gave me, was a Hobie 18 mast spanner, which seems to be identical to the ones that are on the European Hobie 14s anyway, so that'll do the job. And I've done one of these before on another Hobie 14 and they work. And you get the kit that comes with it to mount it. This comes from Hobie Cat, for Scott Lovick Hobie Cat down in Mornington. Can supply all your Hobie needs. And we have a packet. And in this packet, we'll have a look what we get. We get a bit of useless tape. I've never known what that was really for. And you get a bunch of rivets. And a rod that goes through the mast so you don't crush the mast when you do up the bolt. And I do have the bolt somewhere. And you get these side plates that rivet on. And you get the rivets and all the waterproof rivets and stuff. So we're going to have a look where this actually mounts. Now the optimum position for the mast spanner is about 14.5 inches. From the bottom of the mast, but I'm going to go a little bit higher anyway, just so I'm not in the way of this horn. I actually want to put that horn back on there, so anywhere above there is good for me, where the horn is. So somewhere up around 15.5 inches, 16 inches should be okay. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make a foam block to go up the mast above the mast spanner, because the mast spanner could leak. It is open to the water if you go turtle. So we're going to make it out of this is rubber foam. You get it from Clark Rubber. It's a charcoal rubber foam, GVA 30. It's the part number is 32973, and it's waterproof. It should do the job. We're just going to press it on here and mark it. You can do that. It sort of marks pretty well. We can probably chop that out. I'll chop it out with I'm just going to use a coping saw. Make it a little bit bigger than it needs to be. Probably slice him off there. There's a plug. We'll just see how tightly that fits. We'll put the plug in. It's a nice tight fit. As you can see, it's nice to work with too. So it'll be able to push that right up there above the mast spanner position. I'm just gonna tape a dry cloth on here and just dry off the mast in there. Just gonna dry the inside of the mast with a heat gun. Just give it a bit of warmth to completely dry it out. A couple of minutes on that heat gun should dry any water up. So we've worked out on the other side of the mast, we've measured up and in. So we're going to drill this side of the mast for the 10mm spacer that goes in the mast in this position here. We took our measurement from this hole here, we measured up and measured it rather than drilling straight through. Probably miss it. Better to measure it on the other side and drill two separate holes and then put the big drill through. So here we're going to measure the spacer, get the right hole size. You can see it's 9.5, the size of that. And the best drill to use is one slightly smaller. We're going to use 9.37, and the spacer measures 9.47. So we don't want the hole too big, that's for sure. So we'll drill through. The other side going as well, so it'll be this hole. And we'll find both holes. Space is probably not quite going to go in there. So we might just open that up a little bit, should be able to belt it in there. So we've put just a center line on this bit of foam. We're gonna just put a smear of silicon just on the center of it, roughly here. Just give it a little bit of silicon. Poke it in, just like that. You can push it all the way down with a stick. Some kind of a stick here. And let's push it down to the right spot, roughly. It's about 350mm. I'm going to turn it around now. You can actually turn this thing. That's it, it's turned around. I'm just going to jiggle it into the right spot. mark this stick, I'll be able to gently push it up. Actually, yep, getting there. See the texture. Texture mark is right there. Push the bottom down a bit. Texture mark on the bottom. As you can see, texture mark that side. And we've got the texture mark there. So we've got the foam right over the hole. You can see the foam is right up square and snug with silicon around it. So I was able to drill perfectly through there. So I've gone through the middle of the foam. The foam's 40 mil thick. So that bolt will be waterproof even through the middle of the foam there. So just a bit of silicon. And this bolt should almost try and lever it down slightly. There it goes. We've got a good tight fit there. So we've got to trim the bolt to size, that's what we're going to do now. It's too long at the moment. So the bolt's not on the right angle, so we're just going to make it slightly more flat. A bit more the right angle of the mast now. Alright, so what I've done, I've put the spacer in. These are all the things that come in the packet. They come flat, but you've got to sort of bend them just a little bit to suit the shape of the mast. So you just put them in the vise and give them a bit of a bend, and they fit over. They need to stick up about half a millimetre each side. They've got to protrude higher than the plate. Slightly higher, or almost flush is fine, but I've got them just slightly higher. I've just put a little bit more silicon up the end there, just on the end of the foam, just to seal it off a little bit stronger. Here we've got some of these waterproof rivets. I can't think what the real name is for them, but they come in the pack. And it's just a little bit of silicon under the head of it. Get that in there, then you need to drop it in the hole. So we're just going to rivet this on. And we do them all. Well, that's one side done. We'll roll it over and we'll do the other side. We'll do the other side with the lazy tong rivet gun. Sometimes the rivets drop in. Which is a real nuisance. We've got one to go. Perfect. Nice. And just give it a clean up with the silicon. It's looking good. Both sides are done. Next thing is to, we'll put the spanner on shortly. Righto, finally. Time to put the spanner on. And we'll just try and carefully ease this through there. There's a, put a washer on there. In the right spot, it will tighten up nicely. Another washer on there, and then the nylock nut. To do it up. Do it up through the tension. So that it's not too tight, not too loose, and it moves. Feels pretty good. Fairly straight. And it's able to swing like that. And it swings past these rivets because it's slightly lower than horizontal. So it clears those rivets nicely. That's a mast spanner for a Hobie 14. Ready to go. Now I've got another bit of foam in here. It's even tighter. Fits really tightly. I'll put a little bit of silicone on it, and then we'll put the mast base on. I'll put the mast base on with a bit of silicone. Some more rivets in.
another one in here. Clean all that up. And there's just a couple of leftover rivet holes in here from the original bit of foam block in there. So we just drill them a little bit. A little bit of silicone on them all. And I've done the boom. I've already put the cleat on the boom back at the yacht club earlier on. This last bit done. And the very last rivet. There we go. All the rivets done. No fail. Here we go. So tomorrow we'll put it in the swimming pool and we'll just see that it's waterproof and there's no leaks on the rest of the mask as well.